So a lot of people ask for an example of a BIM execution plan. So I thought I would take us through an example as we create it and then as we can export it. Let me even do it inside of a free account so that we can take a look. The BIM execution plan incorporates documents and also scope, which is a set of tasks. So if I call this a BIM execution plan, and the first thing that we'll be presented with inside of Planoly is a set of the templates. And I'm going to simply say I would like a BIM execution plan. I'd like to wrap it in appointment documents. I'd like to track our meeting minutes, for example. And if I hit create, this will create me three tabs with everything that is ready for me to fill out. And they can be things like using some of these lists and removing some items, adding things, changing things, etc., making it project specific. And then in the scope, that's where we get into the detailed task requirements. And I could import something, I could create something from scratch, or I could use templates. And if I have things like activities that I would like to drag in, or building systems and spaces and etc., or if I've already defined something before and I have a scope on a previous project, then I can simply say, I'm going to choose that. I choose a couple of the milestones, decide what I want to import, and then I'm going to simply follow the ISO 19650 workflow. And here's one I prepared earlier, so you can get into all the details. Let's roll it up so that we don't see as many line items. And now we've got all of the tasks for each stage, and they range from setting up the information manager, so appointing somebody to undertake all of these responsibilities, through to having a drone survey, so you have different task and master information delivery planning, all of the detailed responsibilities for modeling, and that goes down into column foundations that are required at this point in time, and even down to this example is built out with some stairs and some properties. So here we're looking for the compression strength and the finish of the concrete for these detailed elements that are coordinated by the structural team. So pretty quick to run down, and also some assets as well with spaces and even the rooms. They're looking for the overall height, the barcode, and whether they are accessible or not. So pretty simple to get to this, but the export that you were looking for is a PDF. Going to exports, create a PDF, let's choose everything in here, and also all of the different documents in the plan. Let's may as well choose everything in the setup as well, so we get a really detailed scope. We could drag and drop any additional appendices as well, define who needs to see it, and hit create. There's a whole bunch of other settings in there as well, but let's have a look at the resulting document. So this is now compiling all of the documents, whether they are text-based, images, tables, anything that's in the plan in those documents, and then also the grids of requirements and the tasks and all of their definition and any attachments or links out to anything else. So this PDF is now, is now here, and it also follows a full hierarchy, so we can look inside of the BIM execution plan, look at the introduction, look at the different standards that we're following and technology that we're using, and then also in the appointment documents, what the information particulars are, etc. So that's all, and then let's roll this up and look at the scope details, for example, so we can start to see information manager as a task and the checklist of items as well. So, and then yeah, if we looked at the grid, scope grid of requirements, this is all referenced as well, so in the grid, this task at stage two, if I clicked on it, is also linked to this task in the details sheet. So you can go backwards and forwards. So hopefully that helps. Yeah, everything from the document index to a cover page, people's contact details, all of the indexes, etc. Everything's created automatically for us, even down to the information legend. So hopefully that helps. That's how to create a very quick set of BIM execution planning documents, resources, and the scope tasks required to execute the work.